Good morning, students. Today it is lecture 22 under the thermal properties of matter. In the last class we have learnt about the concept of the modes of heat transfer. Under that we have learnt convection. Okay, now today let us go for the third mode of transfer of heat. It is called radiation. Radiation, and already you are familiar about the conduction and convection. Today let me highlight you about the radiation. Here in this, the radiation, this is the third mode of transfer of heat. Okay, but here we do not require particles. Please remember, do not require particles, nothing but do not require medium. You can also say it does not require medium. So what do you mean by this means? Without the medium you can explain the one radiation concept. But the first two, conduction and convection, these two require material medium. So these requires material medium. Also we have said, when I say medium, it is understood nothing but it requires particles. This you are already familiar under the one, the conduction and convection, where it requires a material medium. And but radiation do not require material medium. Hope you know material medium is nothing but particles. So how do you explain this? In the early class, the modes of transfer of heat, the first class I gave an example where giving an apple to the first boy in the sitting in a bench, I said to him to transfer that apple to the last bench. So what he has done? He has only transferred the apple. He did not change his position. He did not move from his position. Only the apple has been reached the last bench boy. And therefore we said it is the example for conduction. Similarly, I gave an example for the convection where I said that boy, the first bench boy, he went from the first bench and he to reach the last bench boy, and he has given the apple to him, where it was an example for convection. The third example I gave, the first boy throw that apple to the last bench boy. That last bench boy catches the apple, where it is an example for radiation. So these concepts I said in the early class, where you can also remember the conduction, where in this I said the one object which is having the particles, maybe the atoms or the molecules which are there in this, where here if I heat it, the only first particle gets heated up, it starts vibrating with the larger amplitude as you are giving continuous heat to this end, due to which it starts vibrating with the larger amplitude, due to which the neighboring particle gets heated up and this has been transferred the one energy to it. So this continues up to here, but this molecule does not move to the last part of this end, but only the one energy is transmitted, we said, under the one concept of conduction. But in the second case, convection, where the particles move from one end to the other, today I am saying here the radiation do not require medium or do not require particles means for this I give an example here where let me say this is an object. This object is placed in the atmosphere. It is placed in the atmosphere. Let me say sun is at this position. Sun is at this position where you can say the sun is radiating heat. And these will the heat waves which are reaching this object. It is reaching this object due to which you can say the one heat waves are transferred from sun to the object. You can say it has one the heat waves from the sun. So sun is radiating heat and light to the earth. So our object is on the earth. Let me say our object is on the earth. So sun is far away from us. It is radiating heat as well as light. But we need at present heat. So sun is radiating heat due to which these waves are reaching this the one object. Okay. So these are reaching the object means these are called as heat waves. These heat waves reach the object. And as and when the heat waves are reaching the object means this object starts getting heated. This starts getting heated. So as and when it receives heat from the sun, it gets heated up. Heated up. Okay. This gets heated up. Because the sun radiates heat, it gets heated up and due to which this one will be getting the temperature rises to this object. Okay? Now, as and when this gets heated up, after some time it starts radiating. This starts radiating. So, this you can observe here. As and when it receives the heat from the sun, it will get heated up, the temperature rises and as after some time, it starts radiating heat. Okay, so this is how you can observe here. Remember I said the waves are coming from sun to the earth. Directly you are getting heat from the sun to the earth. In between, you do not require medium. It will be traveling in the atmosphere. It does not require medium. Hence you can say that does not require medium. And at the same time, heat waves are reaching the earth. So, let me say, these heat waves are none other than electromagnetic waves. These are called as electromagnetic waves. So, you can remember, this electromagnetic waves are different types of different wavelength. They will be having different wavelength and different electromagnetic waves will be there of different wavelength. In that, most probably you have learnt in the school days, some of the concepts like heat waves, maybe you might have high, let me say the sun is radiating heat means it is radiating in the form of heat waves. This you have learned example here. Similarly, if you are seeing the object through your eyes and that is none other than called as light waves. Seeing object. Seeing objects means you can say it emits light waves. Okay? Light waves. Right. At the same time, today you are using mobiles. These mobiles are also one type of electromagnetic waves. They are nothing but called as radio waves. So, you can give an example like mobiles where they are nothing but the one waves which are radiating from the mobiles are nothing but called as the one the radio waves. These are due to what means radio waves. Similarly, you have various types of waves I said. Nothing but electromagnetic waves of different wavelength. In that you come across X-rays, UV rays, etc., infrared rays, all these you come across here. So these you come across X-rays, UV rays, infrared rays, ultraviolet rays, all will come under electromagnetic waves. Okay, so now you have come to know about the different types of radio waves, electromagnetic waves which are having different wavelength are named as different type. One as radio waves, maybe the light waves, maybe the one heat waves, X-rays, UV rays, lights. So you now you are familiar about the electromagnetic waves. So detailed concept about these electromagnetic waves you learn in the second year. You have one chapter based on electromagnetic waves of different characteristics of different waves. These you learn in the next year, in second year. present I require only the heat waves, so I'll explain based on that heat waves. Okay, the waves which are coming from the one sun reaching the object and gets heated up, and due to which it radiates heat, and they are none other than called as the one radiating heat, means they are called as thermal radiations. They are also called as the one called as these radiating heat means they are called as thermal radiations. Thermal radiations. So please remember, you have the one concept called thermal radiations, right? Okay. So the electromagnetic radiations emitted in the wire body by virtue of its temperature. The electromagnetic radiations emitted by the body by virtue of its temperature is called as thermal radiations. Okay, these thermal radiations are also called as they are emitting radiations. So you can say the one very simple example, the one radiations emitted by the red hot. Examples for this is the one radiations emitted by red hot. Okay, so this is the one radiations emitted by red hot iron, or maybe the one you can say light from the filament lamp. You can red hot, that is red hot iron, you can say. Also you can give examples like light emitted by the one filament, light emitted by filament. So these are some examples you can observe under the one thermal radiations. So the one will continuously, they are emitting radiations. You can say 24 hours the objects will be emitting radiations. So they are on the earth, you can come across all the objects will receive heat from the sun. They get heated up, and due to which their temperature rises, and hence they emit radiations, and this emission of radiations will be continuous. It will be all the 24 hours it will be emitting radiations. So this you should be familiar about, the one radiations. Okay, now the next part, let me just give some concept about the properties of thermal radiations. So let me give the one concept of properties of thermal radiations. Thermal radiations. So remember, when once you know the properties of electromagnetic radiations, all these concepts are good enough to explain the thermal radiations, because thermal radiation is one electromagnetic wave. So whatever the properties you come across in electromagnetic waves, that holds good for thermal radiations. In your school days, you might have heard about the one electromagnetic waves, some of the properties of electromagnetic waves. So all those you can highlight here, but at present I just highlight some of the one properties which are very important properties. Many the one properties are there. At present I highlight few things which are familiar to you, and you can recall the one properties which you have learned in the school days, right? Now, to explain the properties of thermal radiations, first let me say the first point. These are electromagnetic waves. So these are electromagnetic waves. So the one thermal radiations are electromagnetic waves having wavelength ranging between one. These electromagnetic waves having wavelength. Having wavelength ranging from 1 micrometer to 100 micrometer. You already know the wavelengths are expressed in terms of meters. So you are writing the one electromagnetic waves. In that, the thermal radiations, we are speaking today only thermal radiations. So this thermal radiations ranging between 1 micrometer to 100 micrometer. What do you mean by micro? Micro means it is of 10 raised to minus 6. So micrometer means 1 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter to, you can say 100 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter. So the range is nothing but the wavelength which So you have different wavelengths or having different wave. The one radiations I said already, like light waves, radio waves. So today we are learning thermal radiations of this range. Okay. So these electromagnetic waves, or you can say these thermal radiations. What you say here? These are just like light waves. What do you mean to say? They are just like light waves means, please remember, I explain some of the principles which we come across in light waves. They hold good also for thermal radiations. So these light waves, even this also you learn next year under the one geometrical optics. Also we come across one more called as wave optics. There you learn the concept of the one light regarding geometrical optics as well as wave optics. So let me say some of the concepts here, where these light waves always they travel in straight line. So whenever they travel in straight line, you can say the light waves travel in straight line. So they also obey the concept of the one light waves, explains the similar concept for thermal radiation. So today you are ready to say even our thermal radiations also travel in straight line. So the one thermal radiations also travel in straight line. So please remember, these also travel in straight line. Like light waves, the one thermal radiations also travel in straight line. So this you will never agree as I say just directly straight line. We have to remember some of the concepts obey this principle. So whenever I say waves, light waves, maybe the thermal radiations, they are traveling in straight line, means they obey the principle of light. They obey principles like the one called as reflection, refraction, etc. So these compulsory reflection, refraction concept obey in light waves. Similarly, our thermal radiation also obeys the concept of reflection and refraction. Hope you this also you might have heard in your school days, but detailed concept you learn in second year regarding the one reflection and refraction. At present I just explain few things regarding reflection and refraction. Okay,
right.
So now you have learned one more concept, where it is our thermal radiation also travels in a straight line just like light waves, obey the principle of reflection and refraction. Okay. Now the third point, this like light waves, our thermal radiations also travel in the form of waves. So they travel in form of waves. So they travel in the form of waves means it obeys the principle of interference. So light waves obeys the this concept you will learn very clearly in the next year in the light waves. So it obeys interference, diffraction, and polarization. So these three phenomena explains the concept of light travels in the form of waves. But even today, the thermal radiations also travel in the form of waves, just like light waves. Hence, it also exhibit interference, diffraction, and polarization. Hope you understood what I said just now. So remember, the thermal radiations obeys the one interference, diffraction, and polarization. Okay. One more point I want to say here. This thermal radiations produce heat. As and when the heat is incident on it, it always produces the one heat radiations. Right? As and when this heat is fallen on the object, it produces the heat radiations. And those heat radiations will be explaining the one, maybe the concept of the absorption, maybe the transmission, maybe the one reflections. So all these concepts will explain. So let me tell you what are those things. So just remember, as and when this the one sun emits like the one heat waves, it will reach the one object, it gets heated up inside, it starts emitting radiations, and those radiations which are emitting continuously with the one because of heat waves which is receiving from the sun, they are called as thermal radiations. And and these thermal radiations, as and when they get heat, the radiating heat, heat from the sun means it is radiating heat means it also explains the concept of when maybe the one object, maybe sometimes it exhibits the one partly the one the absorption, maybe the one reflection, maybe the transmittance. All these concepts you can explain for the one for a given object. Okay, let me tell you what are the possibilities. Now let me say here, if this is our object, let me say our object is this one. Remember, to explain this thermal radiations, it has some properties where, remember, these objects will be explaining the one means this will be having some area. It will also depend on nature and also depends on the surrounding medium. So our object is placed now in the atmosphere. Okay, when the object is placed in the atmosphere, now a cube quantity of heat is incident on this. Cube quantity of heat is incident on this object. Incident on this object means what happens if this object is, what, whenever it is incident on it, a partly amount, the part of that amount of heat which is received on it will be reflected like this. So this is reflected. Okay, so if the remaining part of it is absorbed, you can say it is absorbed. Some part of it will be emitting out of the object. It is called as transmitted. So remember, a cube quantity of heat is applied to a given object. So in that, what happens? A part of it is reflected, a part of it is absorbed, a part of it is radiated. So nothing but transmitted. Let me say a part of it is transmitted. So let me write where cube quantity of heat is incident on it. That is a QA, that is QR, first one, QA plus QT. So here the unit quantity of heat, is supplied to you. A part of it is absorbed, a part of it is reflected, a part of it is transmitted. So this is how you can explain how heat is incident on it, what happens to the given object. Okay, so few objects. Let me say here, in this, where unit quantity of heat I said. So if Q is equal to 1, unit quantity of heat is equal to R plus A plus T. Hope you understood now. What is R? R is said to be reflection. A is said to be absorption. T is said to be transmission. So here, a unit quantity of heat is supplied. So in this, if a given object, in this, by chance, if there is, if A is equal to 0, means A is equal to 0 means no absorption, and T is equal to 0 means what happens if A is equal to 0, T is equal to 0, then you can say therefore R is equal to 1. What do you mean to say? Here, a part of the unit quantity of heat is supplied to a given substance, a part of it is nothing but, that is, no amount of heat is absorbed. So no amount of heat is absorbed, no amount of heat is transmitted. So whatever the heat is transmitted is completely reflected, and therefore R is equal to 1. We say this is said to be called as good reflectors. We call it as good reflectors. So when I say good reflectors means there is nothing but, they are also called as bad absorbers. So you can say bad absorbers. I think you are able to catch this word. Good reflectors, I said. No absorption, no transmission. Only the whatever the heat is applied is completely reflected. Right. Now, first, this is first point. What is the second point? If I say, if the R is equal to 0, T is equal to 0, means no amount of it is reflected. Whatever the heat is applied, no amount of it is reflected. No amount of it is transmitted. Means therefore A is equal to 1. What do you mean to say A is equal to 1? They are called as good good absorbers. They are called good absorbers. Right? Now, at the same time, if complete amount of heat, whatever it is incident, it is saw no amount of it is reflected, no amount of it is transmitted. You can also call it as perfect absorbs. You can also say the word called as perfect absorbs. Perfect absorbs. Right? Similarly, this is also called as perfect reflectors. Right? So now, for these, I just give some examples you come across in your day-to-day life. You have various colors. Different colors are there. Those colors will behave different concept. Now for this two examples, I just give an example of the one good reflectors, where I give the example of color is white color. If I say white colors are said to be good reflectors. So whatever the heat is instant on it, the one whatever the heat which is instant, that completely reflects. So white color is said to be a good reflectors. And also remember, during summer we prefer to use white cloths. Particularly in summer we prefer to use cotton cloths, white cotton cloths. So let me say one more point. Only white color, if I say, it's a good reflector. Cotton means, you know, that cotton dress will be having small pores in it, due to which you can just be comfortable during summer. Because of small pores, air will be entering into it. You feel comfortable to wear white cotton cloths during summer. Right? Similarly, you can also keep good absorbers. Good absorbers means black color. Where black color is a good absorber. So whatever the heat is there, it is completely absorbed. No amount of it is reflected. So whenever the, whatever the heat is there, it is completely absorbed, means it is acting as a good absorber. So preferably, you will never wear black colors during the summer. Because you feel very hot. So as and when the heat is instant on it, complete heat is absorbed in it, due to which you feel very hot to wear cotton cloth, that is black color, during summer. Hence we prefer to use white cotton dresses during summer, because we are acting as a good reflectors. Hope you understood what I say just now. This good absorbers, wear black colors, you will never prefer to use in summer. Because complete, whatever the heat is there, it is completely absorbed. You feel much hot. Already in summer it will be very hot. At the same time you will feel much more hot. Hence you will never be comfortable during summer to wear cotton, that is black dresses during summer. Okay, right. So for this I can give one more very good example. You have seen aeroplanes. These aeroplanes, whichever the one, maybe the one companies you can say, whichever the company aeroplanes you can say. So if you observe the aeroplanes, these aeroplanes are coated with white paint, because these aeroplanes are flying high in the sky. Since they are high in the, they are flying high in the sky, naturally the one heat radiations will be reaching very soon to the one aeroplanes, rather than reaching to the earth. So it will also reach the earth, the sunlight will be reaching the earth. But these are flying at high altitudes, they will get more heat. Hence, as and when the heat is instant on the one aeroplanes, naturally if all the heat is absorbed, naturally the one passengers who are sitting in the aeroplane will never be comfortable. Hence, we always the aeroplanes, outside part of the aeroplanes are coated with white paint. Hence, the passengers who are sitting inside the aeroplane feel comfortable even during summer, as and when the aeroplane fly high in the sky. Right? So this is how we can observe for good reflectors. Okay. Now I have explained the concept of the one reflectors and also the one good absorbers. Let me stop now today. Again I explain some more concepts based on the one perfect absorbers, where I said this color is black. Okay, using this I'll explain some more concept based on perfect black body. Now let me just stop for this concept now. I'll explain some more concept here now. Remember, whenever the heat is instant on it, I said, heat is instant, it will absorb heat. Naturally, the one reaches the one's object, due to which it gets heat up, and whenever it gets heat up, the temperature increases, and if the temperature increases, the one it starts radiating heat, I said. In that, object will become will be acting as a cold objects. Okay, if the radiations are less, then whatever the heat which is incident heat is it receiving, and it is only that is nothing but if the one radiating heat is less, at that time you give an example of hot objects. I'm very sorry, I said cold, but now remember, I'll repeat once again. If more amount of heat is incident on it, of a given object, it receives more heat, but it emits less heat. Means it emits, it radiates less amount of heat, means it will be acting as a hot object. By chance, if the heat received is very less, but a more amount of heat is emitted, means that will be acting as a cold object. So these concepts you know very well. Now let me explain some more concept on this. So I just give some example now. If this object is already the one sunlight which is receiving heat is reaching to the earth. Reaching to this object. So if the one, if large amount of heat, if it receives a large amount of heat, then if heat, but less amount of heat is radiated, then you can say this is explaining that is hot objects, right? Similarly, vice versa. If I say vice versa, means you can observe if the one receiving large, if he receiving less amount of heat, but more amount of heat is radiated, then that object will become cold object. It is a natural phenomena. You can observe this. You come across. It's a very simple logic. It is. You can observe. It's a very simple logic. If the object receives large amount of heat and only less amount of heat is radiated, it is said to be called as hot objects. If the one object which is receiving less amount of heat but more amount of heat is emitted, it is said to be called as cold objects. So it's a very simple logic, you can understand easily. Now using this, now I want to explain some of the concepts in this radiation. What do you want to say here? Means a scientist, a famous scientist by name Newton, he has explained some rules to explain these concepts. So he has explained some rules, and with the help of that rules, he has also done the experiment in the laboratory, and he has found the one experimental evidence, and he explained that concept, that is none other than called as Newton's law of cooling. He has explained the one concept called Newton's law of cooling. Hope you understood. Now I am explaining about radiation. In that I am explaining these concepts, where in that some amount of heat is lost. So when the loss of amount of heat is observed, that he has explained by doing some experiment. He has also given some evidence with all graphical representation, with mathematical derivations. He has proved that, and he has done the experiment in the laboratory, and he found that the evidence to that, and therefore that experiment whatever he has done, and the explanation what he has given for that experiment is, it is called Newton's law of cooling. It is called Newton's law of cooling. So the Newton's law of cooling uses the concept of radiation. That is, among the three modes of transfer of heat, it uses the concept of radiation. So let me explain what does he explains in his the one experiment, what are the rules he has used in it, and how you come across in our day to day life. Okay, for this simple example, you can observe, suppose if you have already heated a bucket of hot water, you already heated that, that is already one bucket of hot water is there. Maybe the temperature is maybe of 90 degrees centigrade. Earlier starting temperature is 90. After some time, after 15 minutes, if you observe, it starts getting cooling, means rapid cooling takes place. Means the 90 degree after 15 minutes, the one bucket of water will become cool very fast, that you can observe. Within that, nothing but your 90 degree will become 70 degree very fast. the first interval. Similarly, if you cool it for another 10 minutes, what happens? It cools for 50 degrees centigrade. Very fast it will cool. Similarly, nothing but earlier it was 90, it will become 70. Second interval, let me say from 70 to 60 degree it will come. It will take some time interval to cool it. After the third interval, what he observes, now the cooling goes on decreasing. Means now it slowly decreases. Earlier it decreases very, the cooling has taken very fast, but after some interval of time, it cools very slowly. This he has observed in the one experiment. That you also observe in your day-to-day life. At home, you can see complete one bucket of water, if it is hot water, if it is having 90 degrees centigrade, if you observe this after 15 minutes, it will reach to 70 degree. After 10 minutes, if you observe, that is again next 15 minutes, let me say, second interval, at that time it will reach the 160 degree. Now it has decreased. Now after the 15 minutes, again if you observe, that 60 degree has become nothing but 50 degree. It means it takes 15 minutes to cool it. It means nothing but it has 60 degree will become, let me say, 55 degree. It takes some time. Means cooling has become very slow. So this year you can observe in our day-to-day life. Similarly, I'll explain how this you can see from the graph. Okay, let me now go for the next concept. Newton's law of cooling, which uses the concept of radiation, and this was explained by famous scientist by name Newton. Hence that the experiment is itself has explained Newton's law of cooling. Okay,
right.
Even in your laboratory, you do this experiment. By chance, if you expect this for the one practical exam, total 30 marks practical exam will be there for one experiment. There you are doing performing the experiment, Newton's law of cooling, for 30 marks. If you are writing the one theory paper, you expect one compulsory 5 mark question where explain the Newton's law of cooling, they will ask. At that time, they also explain, they give the question, obtain the mathematical expression for Newton's law of cooling. There you are deriving the mathematical expression for 5 marks. Okay. Similarly, you also expect one 5 mark problem here. So it's very, very important for both exam point of view and also in our day-to-day life, you come across this example. So be prepared to remember the things correctly here. Okay, this Newton's law of cooling uses the concept of, it is one of the concept, it uses the concept of radiation. Among three modes of transfer of heat, it uses the concept of radiation, right? So here, what you observe here means, here according to Newton, he explains the rate of loss of heat by radiation. He explains rate of loss of heat. Rate of loss of heat by radiation. This is the one concept you come across under Newton's law of cooling. Okay, this is first point. And here in this, what are the things to be remembered here means Newton's law of cooling. Here we explain three points. One is the first point, temperature of the body. Temperature of the body. Okay. Second point, temperature of the surroundings. Temperature of the surroundings. Of the surroundings. Okay. Third point, it depends on nature. nature and area of the material. Nature and area of the material. So remember here, 3 points to be remembered here. The one, nature and area of the material, and the one, time which is exposed to the one, maybe for radiations. You can say the one, nature and extent of the surface, exposed to the surface, exposed means at what time you are exposing to this. Extent, at what extent means what time required to the one surface, to the one which is exposed to it, right? So these are the three methods. Remember here, nature of the material. So which type of material you are using, what type of material you are, the one with a good absorber, good reflectors, what we are using, and area, whatever the one amount of the one area of the given object depends on that. So here, let me give one best example here. If this is the one object, let me say this is the object. Here, if this object is already heated up, whenever it is heated up means it gets heated up. Let me say temperature T1 means the temperature of the body. And this body is exposed to the atmosphere. So here it is in the atmosphere it is. So here the temperature outside this. So the temperature outside this body is T2. So let me say temperature of the body is T1. Temperature of the surrounding body is T2. Right? So here the third point, you already know what type of material you are using, the nature of the material. Similarly, the one surface area, whatever the surface area of that material. At the same time, what time is required, means at what extent you are exposing this to the one outside surface. So these 3 points you have to be familiar. Okay, now for this I just gave a hot water bucket, will be cooling very fast in the first interval, and second interval it becomes slightly less. The third interval it is still becoming very less. The third interval means cooling is going on decreasing here with respect to time. Means you can remember temperature versus time. If you draw the graph, if you draw the graph, the one temperature versus time. This is delta T, means difference in temperature versus time. You can observe this type of graph. This is how you can observe. So what you observe here, in the first interval, it rapidly decreases here. This is the one first interval. In the second interval, it decreases like this. In the third interval, like this. So here remember, the one rapidly decreasing during first interval, and secondly slowly, third still slowly it will be decreasing. So you can observe this type of graph, where you can observe the one temperature versus time graph. You can see this one. So this is how you can observe here, how it decreases. Temperature goes on decreasing like this. So here the first interval rapidly decreases. Again it decreases like this. Again it will be decreasing like this. So this is how it goes on decreasing. Right? So this is what you can remember. Well, now let me explain the one. The mathematical expression for this Newton's law of cooling. This is the one theory concept I said just now. Let me prove this by mathematical expression. Okay. So the mathematical expression for Newton's law of cooling. Now let me go for the next part. That is mathematical expression. This is a very big derivation is there. So I need this board. I'll just close one of this board. Because I need completely to explain this derivation. So let me go for the one. Mathematical expression. Let me say the mathematical expression for Newton's law of cooling, right? So this is the one very very important for 5 mark problem, maybe theory or problem. You will expect this both. So wherever you come across, you should remember this one. So what do you observe from this one means, here consider a hot body of temperature T, and now this body is kept in the surrounding. Let me say the temperature is T0. Now using these two conditions, let us learn one concept here. So according to him, the Newton's law of cooling, rate of loss of heat is directly proportional. was here. The one rate of loss, L-O-S-S, please remember, loss, some loss of heat is there. So you should not be get confused, you should not read L-A-W, it is L-O-S-S, rate of loss of heat. Rate of loss of heat is directly proportional to temperature difference between system and surroundings. So this is a very simple statement and this carries marks. You have to remember this statement. According to Newton's law of cooling, how did he states? Rate of loss of heat is directly proportional to temperature difference between the system and the surroundings. Already I said, if this is the one object, this object is having temperature T. Surrounding is, this is T naught. So temperature difference between T and T naught. This is how you can remember. And here rate, what do you mean by rate? First let me say, the quantity of heat means Q. A small quantity of heat means it is dQ. Suppose with respect to time, if you are saying dQ by dT. I think hope you understood what I said just now. Q is the quantity of heat. So small amount of heat you are explaining here, loss of heat, small amount. So it is dQ. But remember here, with respect to time you say rate of loss of heat. Rate means with respect to time. Loss means you are getting it is decreasing. So let me write according to this statement. Here it is dQ. Means dQ is a small amount of heat. Small amount of heat. dQ by dT. Rate of heat. Okay. This is minus dQ by dT. Rate of loss of heat. I think you have understood what I said. Rate of loss of heat. I'll write from here this side. Please observe. dQ is the small amount of heat with respect to time means rate of heat means rate of loss means minus is proportional to temperature difference T minus T naught. Hope you understood now. What does this negative sign indicates? Negative sign indicates the law, that is negative sign indicates loss of heat. Loss of heat. I think you understood what I said. Negative sign. Rate means always with respect to time you say. Okay. Rate of loss of heat is directly proportional to temperature difference between the system. This is the system. This is the surrounding. So there is a temperature difference between system and surroundings. You get this expression. Now this becomes, now the next part, minus dQ by dT is equal to, I am removing the proportionality. Now you get a constant. This constant is K. Let me write this is small k, because once again I should write K. So I will write small k, T minus T naught. What is this K called as? K is called proportionality constant. Proportionality constant. Constant. Okay. Now, one more point I want to say with respect to the one, the amount of heat rate, that is Q amount of heat we have explained here. This we are doing experiment in the one Newton's law of cooling using calorimeter. Last class we have learned calorimeter, that using that we explained here. So the quantity of heat mainly depends on three factors. It depends on the amount of, that is Q is directly proportional to mass of the substance. Q is directly proportional to the one temperature difference between it. And at the same time, when you remove the proportionality, you get C, where C is called a specific heat capacity. So it depends on specific heat capacity of the substance. Because you are taking water in a container, means always you require the specific heat capacity of the given substance. So you can say here, this dQ is equal to mC dT. mC dT. What do you mean by this one? Because But now, next step what I do is dq by b. I divide my time into run. I want to explain in terms of the run time. So I write dq is equal to mc dt by dt. Means I am explaining with respect to time. So I am dividing on both the sides. Dq by dt is equal to mc dt by dt. Right?
Okay.
Now you know dq by dt is this expression. Now you already know here in this one, this is equation 1. Now you know what is dq by dt here. This is 2. So from 1 and 2, you can observe wherever you are dq, you can use this condition. So at that time, equating equation 1 and 2. Equating equation 1 and equation 2. We get. You can remember, if I substitute here, you get minus mc dt by dt is equal to, that is, you can say k into t minus t naught. Hope you understood this expression. Let me, proportionality, this I take this at equation 1, because already I have removed the proportionality, so I will take this one, you can get this, right? Now, the next step is, you can write dt by dt is equal to k, this minus will come this side, that is, I can take here mc, let me write this as minus, t minus t naught. I'm just rewriting the expression now. Means, I want to keep this one dt by dt. This is temperature. This is time. Here, k by mc into t minus t naught. In the next step, what I want to do is, I just want to equate only the temperature one side. Only the temperature one side. So, I rewrite the equation now. Dt by t minus t naught is equal to minus k by mc into dt. So this minus k by mc itself, I give one more constant, I represent now like this, dt by t minus t naught is equal to k dt. Hope you understood now, I have taken capital K. What is this capital K? This is minus k by mc. I have taken this condition. Right? Now again I have taken this constant k by mc is equal to capital K. Right? Now we have separated all temperature one side, time one side. So now next step is we have to take the one logarithms on both. Means nothing but integrating first. Let me integrate this on both the sides. This integration you learn in second year. At present you just remember how I am integrating this. So I have to use integration. Only integration I am doing. Common integration. I am not going for the one definite integrals. When I go for definite integrals, I should use limits. Here I am not using some limits. Because outside atmosphere, whatever may be the one range. So I will not take one, the limits here. I just only integrate it. So integrating on both sides. Integrating on both sides. So integrating on both sides means we get, what is it? That is integral of dt by t minus t naught is equal to integral of k dt. So when once you are integrating means this dt by t minus t naught. So here what happens here means this will become log of, this will become log of t minus t naught. Just you remember this point. The detailed integration concept will learn next year. To only remember this concept, it is enough. Okay. This becomes k. Now here, k is a constant here. So what I just do is, I keep once here like this. Integral of k like this. Sorry. I'll take this common k outside. Integral of dt. I'll keep it as it is. Only this side I have integrated. Now let me write log t minus t naught is equal to k integral of dt, it will become t. When once you completed the integral, you have to put constant, that is kt plus c. Integral of dt is t plus c. What is the c? called as, where C is called as integration constant. This is integration constant. After completing the one integration, you write the one constant for it. Okay, log T by T minus T naught, that is KT plus C. Now let me keep this as it is. For your reference, I just write this is of the form y is equal to mx plus c. You will just remember this. I'll tell you where you come across in graph this expression k into, that is t minus t naught into kt plus c. Let me write the number for this. This is equation number 3. This equation number 3. Okay. Now, to explain this one equation, I just go for the next concept here, where already we got this expression up to 3. Now what I want to do is, I just want to remove this log. So at that time, I can also write like this. I can also write like this. What is it? That is, you can observe this t minus t naught is equal to e to the power of, that is kt. Already we had minus here. This is one minus you had here. Let me keep this as minus itself. Right? This minus as it is. Okay. This is e to the power of minus kt into e to the power of c. Please observe. Here I have removed log. From here already earlier we had log. Now I am removing log means we get e to the power of minus kt. We are explaining in terms of exponentials when you are removing the log. So you get like this. Okay. Now this can also be written as here e to the power of c. Okay. This e to the power of c I can again keep it as constant, I can keep here. So I can write t minus t naught is equal to e to the power of minus kt into c. What is this here? T minus t naught you have now. Let me write t is equal to t naught. I'll take it to the other side. This becomes positive. Here already we have this one. That is t naught plus e to the power of minus kt dot c. This is the one expression you come across here. This is the one fourth equation. Maybe this is third, this is fourth equation. So now we have learned four equations in the Newton's law of cooling. Right? What is this c? The c is nothing but called as e to the power of c. I'll write here. What is this c? The c is equal to e to the power of c. This I have taken a constant. Okay? Right. Now, what do you want to say here now? Just remember, Newton's law of cooling, according to him, first you have to say the statement, that is rate of loss of heat is directly proportional to temperature difference between system and surroundings. So, using this statement, I am writing mathematical expression here, that is minus dq by dt is proportional to t minus t naught. You know, this is temperature difference, this is rate of heat. But since it is loss, I am writing minus. Negative sign indicates loss of heat. Okay. Now I am removing the proportionality to get this. After getting this, what I am doing? I am also using the concept of quantity of heat. How it depends? It depends on two factors. One, mass and temperature. Due to which, if you remove the proportionality, this you learned in the previous class. Where we have learned are using specific heat. Where Q is proportional to M, Q is proportional to, that is T, that is where you can write Q is proportional to, that is nothing but MT, where if you remove the proportionality, you get, that is MCT. Means last class I said theta, here also I write theta, this we have learnt in the earlier class. Today I am replacing this theta by T itself. Using this, now I am writing the equation, substituting this in the equation. That is, we got this equation 2 using this specific heat capacity. Equation 1 was already there. Now equation 2. Now equating equation 1 and 2. Now I am substituting this value in this dq. Right? If you get this one, this equation. Now what I am doing? I am keeping all one side dt by dt
equal to minus k by mc into this one. This I have taken constant where it is represented by k itself. Minus will be continued as it is. Okay. Now, after getting this and keeping all the one temperature one side, time on the other side. So we write temperature this side, time on the other side. Now we just integrate it on both the sides. After integrating, we get this equation. When once you get this equation, again after integrating, completion of integration, we get constant. That is integration constant. So now we have completed three equations. Now I have kept only for your reference. Let me compare this for y equal to mx plus c. Okay. And now the next continuation, I am just equating here. This, when I am removing this log, exponential arises here. That is represented in the term form of e itself. So you get this one from the previous equation. So there are four equations under Newton's law of cooling. Okay. Already I have explained one graph here. Temperature versus time. So temperature versus time means you can observe here. This is temperature versus time. You can observe here. This is temperature. This is time. How it is? They are directly proportional. So temperature versus time, you are drawn. Temperature difference versus time, like this. You have got this one. Here, this expression. Okay. Now, one more point I want to say here. In this case, where temperature versus time, if you observe this graph, this is the graph you can draw, where t minus t naught by time, you get a graph like this, which is a straight line, because this will be showing the one time. This is temperature. So here, this is y intercept. Y is nothing but the temperature along y axis, and time is along x axis. You get a straight line because they are directly proportional here. What does this m indicate? This m indicates the slope that you get from the graph. You just draw the one slope from this. So from getting the one slope from the graph, you can explain this y is equal to mx plus c, which is a straight line graph. But remember, now you have seen this graph straight line, but I am drawing this in the downward direction because this goes on decreasing. Here we have minus, hence it is shown in this direction. So you will draw the graph, you may draw like this. When you draw graph like this, no, it is also straight line, but this is increasing order. But this is decreasing order you have, so you should draw this graph. This graph is wrong. You have to remember this graph. Okay. And already you know the calorimeter, where calorimeter instrument you have seen in the previous class, wherein that we are taking the temperature difference. What is the temperature difference? Earlier the water will be having the one temperature T. As if when you are putting hot water into that, naturally you are just ring the one calorimeter, and due to which there will be fall in the temperature. This temperature, whatever the temperature note down, you note down the temperature. Depending on that, you will take the temperature difference. So in the laboratory, what you do is temperature versus time. You draw the, or you take the set of one readings. So for temperature 90 degree, you will have some time interval. For 80 degree, 70 degree, 60 degree, like this temperature goes on decreasing. But this time interval earlier it was 0 time interval. Now it is 10 seconds. That is 10 minutes. Let me say in terms of minutes it is, because you are waiting for some minutes, it is in terms of minutes. So here 10, 15, 20 minutes. So as the temperature decreases, this time interval increases. So this you are observing this one. Because of this, you get, they are inversely proportional. So you get this type of graph. This is first type. Whatever the note down the temperature, you are getting this, right? Similarly, by chance if you are using this formula, equation number 3, you get this type of graph. If you take the one temperature difference, time interval, and always you get this type of graph, where you can observe this one. Using this equation number 3. Using equation 3, you get this graph. This is the one, by taking set of readings in the laboratory, you
will get the one temperature difference. You will first note down the initial temperature and the temperature, how does it falls. So the difference you take it depending on what you take the time interval and you note down the one graph like this. You will get the step of graph. So in this graph you observe first time, first interval, the fall will be large. In the second interval, it is slightly less. In the third interval, it still becomes less. Means now it goes on decreasing. It means time interval will be less now. Rapidly decreases. Here it slowly decreases. It is still decreasing slowly. So this is how you come across the graph. So here we get two graphs, four equations in the Newton's law of cooling. Again we learn the statement. Using the statement, we learn the mathematical expression. And this uses the concept of laws of heat radiations. That concept you use under Newton's law of cooling. So today we have learned some concepts about radiation. In that we learned thermal radiation. Again we have learned the concept of the one perfect black bodies, that is good absorbers, good reflectors, and some examples. After learning that, we have learned some laws of heat in the nature. That is learned under Newton's law of cooling. Under Newton's law of cooling you have learned statement, mathematical expression. Again in the mathematical expression you learn two graphs and how you do in the laboratory. The one experiment, the one set of readings you will take, depending on that you will draw the graph. So all these we have learned today. So maximum concept we have learned today, and all these are very important for both theory as well as for practicals and for any objective type problems. In Karnataka CET, Common K, maybe in JEE, maybe NEET exam, you will expect one Newton's law of cooling problem which you solve for 5 mark, that is given for objective type problems. At that time we use these expressions. These four expressions you remember. Now let me solve one problem based on this. You will understand much better how to get the one answer for this. Okay, thank you.